Our incline cheater flies are a strength move for our chest, a little bit of the front of the shoulders, and a little bit of our triceps. These are gonna be kind of a combo move between a neutral grip chest press and a normal dumbbell fly or an incline dumbbell fly. You're gonna wanna set a weights for these. You're also gonna want a bench that you can incline to approximately a 45 degree incline. We're gonna sit on down, bring those weights up onto the shoulders. We're gonna use those legs to kick those weights up into that position right above our chest. Rock back, stabilize those shoulders against that bench. We're gonna press up and together. This is our starting point. Palms are in that neutral grip position where they are facing each other. This is where the difference arises between a normal chest fly. So a normal chest fly, remember we're keeping a slight bend in the arms and we're coming out really wide on this one, getting that stretch across the chest. We are gonna be not bending those, or we're gonna be bending those arms a little bit more. So those dumbbells are gonna be in a little closer for this one. This allows us to go a little heavier than we normally can on a regular fly. It allows us to overload the chest a little bit. So instead of coming out nice and really wide for this one, I'm instead gonna bend the arms a little bit more, not all the way to a 90 degree bend where those dumbbells are now just right on the outsides of my chest at the bottom, but I'm gonna bend them slightly to where now those dumbbells are maybe, let's say 10 to 12 inches out from the chest. They're not way out here like a normal fly, but they're not in nice and close here. They're in between. Like I said, this allows us to go a little heavier on this movement. So again, palms facing each other, up above at the top. We're gonna bend those elbows slightly as we come out. Still focus on getting those elbows nice and wide, but those dumbbells now are a lot closer in to the body than they would be on a normal fly. Hence the word a cheater fly. We're slightly cheating on this exercise, not extending out as far in order to go a little heavier and overload the chest. Typically, for many people doing a normal chest fly, this is exactly what I see as the most common mistake. Whenever someone's trying to do a normal chest fly, they end up usually doing a cheater chest fly when they grab a weight that is too heavy for them. Just naturally, the body is not able to extend the arms as far, so they end up unknowingly doing a cheater fly instead of a normal fly. So just be aware of those two separate movements. There's a difference between those. So if you're doing a normal chest fly, make sure you're not doing a cheater fly. Make sure you are going nice and wide and you're having a lighter weight. But if your goal is to do that cheater fly, if that's what that workout says, you're gonna grab a little bit heavier and not be as concerned about extending those arms out nice and wide. Most common mistakes made on this exercise, like I said, confusing it with either a neutral grip chest press or a regular chest fly. Remember those differences. Regular chest fly is nice and wide. Neutral grip, we're ending with the dumbbells kind of right next to the chest here. This is in between. Arms are still slightly bent. Dumbbells are a little out from the chest, but we're not all the way extended out. Another common mistake made on this one, just like pretty much on anything on a bench here with that press, is not having a stable base of support. Make sure those feet are planted on the floor. Make sure those hips and those shoulder blades are planted against that bench throughout that entire movement so that we can stabilize the spine and we can reduce that risk of injury. Lead with the elbows, still trying to get that good stretch across that chest and up into the armpits. And then we are pressing up together and squeezing at the top. So start with a light weight on this move, kind of like you would be doing for a normal chest fly. Get used to kind of the difference between those two movements, and then start to progress up in weight and find a good weight on this one compared to a normal chest fly.